I'm going to show you how to turn your 2D smoke relighting from this to this. Hey everybody, it's Sam from ActionVFX. In this video, I'm going to show you how to take your 2D stock smoke plume assets, create a normal map, and then light that smoke plume to appear as though it's being lit by a fire, all within After Effects. There are two plugins that you need to download before we get into compositing. The first is Normal Mapper for AE on aescripts.com. You have the option to download this plugin for free, but I strongly suggest that you donate whatever you can to this artist as a thank you for making this plugin. The link to download that plugin is in the description. The second plugin is called Normality, and it's by Stefan Minning, a software engineer at Autodesk. This plugin is provided by Stefan completely free, and you can find the link for that down in the description below as well. So pause the video, download those plugins in the description, and then we'll get started. Everything you see in this video, aside from those two plugins, is available to you with an ActionVFX Essentials plan. You don't need an Essentials plan to follow along exactly. We'll be using a free plate from the ActionVFX practice footage library, and our smoke plume will be from our free smoke plumes collection. The purpose here is just to let you know that these capabilities exist and let you get creative with them. Not every asset or situation will be the same. We're going to dive into the basic overviews of this process, but we're going to also explain the why along the way so that you can take this information and these techniques and apply them to whatever scene or situation you run into. So without further ado, let's jump into After Effects. First thing we're gonna do is get our project set up and ready to work within an Aces workflow. If you're not familiar with Aces and you're not exactly sure how to set up Aces within your After Effects project, we made a video that you can check out right here. The first thing we're gonna do is add smoke to our composition and position it where we need it to be. The next step is to pre-compose the smoke layer. We're gonna name it Relit Smoke. From here we have two options and we're gonna go over both. Option one is to pre-compose with Leave All Attributes in Master Comp. Essentially, this is setting up the relighting without having a reference. Option one is better if you prefer having higher quality and the option to adjust the scale and position of your asset later. You'll also generally prefer this method if your shot is static or moving, but the light that's relighting your asset is stationary relative to the asset, such as a fire illuminating a smoke plume. Option two is to pre-compose with Move All Attributes into the new composition. This one is for setting up your relighting with the lighting reference. If you need to adjust anything in post, such as increasing the scale or moving the position, you'll find this one to be more difficult. But it is preferred if you have moving lights within the scene relative to the asset you're attempting to relight, such as if vehicle headlights are moving and relighting the asset. But let's start with option one. Pre-compose with Leave All Attributes. The free smoke asset that we use is a black smoke on a white background, so we're gonna have to do a couple extra steps within this example. If your smoke asset is white on black, you'll find that you won't need to apply the invert effect as many times as we do here. The first thing we're going to do in our relit smoke comp is to duplicate the smoke layer three times. We're gonna name the top layer Normality. The second layer, we're gonna name it Depth Mat. And on this layer, let's go ahead and solo it. Add an invert effect and then add a curves effect. And we're gonna adjust the curves just until we start to see white clipping within our asset. Go ahead and turn that layer off and then name the third layer Normal Map. Let's name the fourth one Texture. Let's solo that layer, add an invert effect, apply an unmult effect, and then we're gonna add another invert effect. We want this asset to be back to having a black texture. So essentially what we need to do is invert it so that now we have a white asset on a black background. The unmult effect will remove that black background and retain our original smoke. And then we're going to invert it again to turn all of the white smoke into black smoke. Let's go ahead and change our viewer from RGB to alpha so we can see what we're doing next. We're gonna add a curves effect and we're gonna adjust the alpha just like we did with the depth map. until we start to see white clipping areas. And then we're gonna add a tint effect to ensure that it is grayscale. Let's switch our view back to RGB view, and then we're going to pre-compose the normal map layer. We're gonna select leave all attributes, and then once inside of that pre-comp, we're gonna apply our normal mapper for AE plugin to that smoke layer. There are a few options in here. One of them is strength. Basically what this does is it allows us to increase the strength of the normal map depending on how solid or opaque our asset is. Since we're wanting to get that solid smoke plume effect, we're going to go ahead and bring our strength up to 100. With the nature of this plugin, we are getting a little bit of artifacting. To fix this, we're gonna add a fast box blur. It doesn't need to be much, it just needs to be enough that we get rid of the artifacting while retaining most of that detail. Somewhere around 1.2 to 1.5 works really well with a 2K asset. Next, let's go back to our relit smoke pre-comp, and then we're gonna go to the normality layer. We need to remove the background from this, so we're going to apply an invert effect and then an unmult effect. And then we're going to add normality. At first, it looks really lame because there's nothing to see. But the next step is where we really start to see just how cool all of this really is. The first thing we're going to do is create a light. I personally find that point lights work best for this kind of situation, but really any type of light will work just fine. I recommend that you set the light to white because this gives us more options in the main composition to composite it exactly how we need it to be. I'm going to go ahead and set my normality layer to 3D. This isn't required, but it does give you different results. Making it 3D has a better light fall off, and for me it also seems to really improve the placement of the light relative to the asset itself. The normality plugin doesn't recommend that you use 3D because it doesn't want that fall off, but we do. Now within normality, let's assign our normal map to our normal map pre-comp. We're also going to assign our depth map to our depth map layer. Make sure that effects and masks is selected. I'm going to go ahead and invert the depth map so that we don't have a bright hot spot in the middle of our smoke. This also helps to illuminate the regions of the smoke better that are thinner smoke and would appear brighter because of the way that light interacts with the smoke particles. The thinner the smoke, the brighter the smoke. So inverting the depth map will really help with that here. Now let's go down here to the bottom right and change it from one view to two views. This is just going to help us position our lights better and see exactly what we're doing. Let's go ahead and finalize the positioning of where we want our light to be. But since fire is three-dimensional and wide, we don't want to just work with one light. We want to have this light coming in from multiple directions. So we're going to actually duplicate this light and move it over to the other side of our smoke. Let's go take a look at it back in our main comp, and it's already looking really good. But let's keep going. The movement of fire is very dynamic, so we want both of these lights to move randomly in a way that feels organic. To do this, we're going to separate the dimensions of the position. Next, we'll alt-click on the stopwatch beside position Y, and we're going to enter the expression wiggle parentheses 3 comma 60. What this expression does is it randomly moves our light up and down by 60 pixels in either direction 3 times a second. We're gonna also add a similar expression to our Z position. Alt click on that stopwatch beside your Z position and type in wiggle parentheses 2 comma 100. Let's go ahead and select both our Y and our Z position, copy those, and just paste them onto our other light source. Both of our lights are now randomly moving around within the Z and Y spaces, almost creating this mesmerizing circular motion. So now when we preview that back, you can see that the lights almost dance along the smoke, creating this appearance that the light is moving just like the fire would be. And just like that, the basics for option one are done. Now let's go on to option two. For option two, we're gonna go back to the beginning of option one when all we've done is position our smoke layer within our composition. We're gonna go ahead and right click on it, select pre-compose, but now we're going to choose move all attributes into new composition. The steps here are similar as they were in our previous one. The difference is now we're going to bring in our plate and any other resources into this composition so that we can animate the lights exactly to anything within the scene that's moving. Once we have our plate and our fire in here, we're going to select them both, right click on them, and set them as guide layers. Now these will not show up back in our main composition, but our smoke will. So now we have the option to go ahead and do all of our lighting within one comp. With this option 2 method, we don't need to use white lights. We can set them to whatever color we want them to be, because we can use a lot of different lights in this setting and get them to match the scene. In my personal opinion, I've used option 1 far more than I've used option 2, but it's really good to know that option 2 exists and be able to leave you with the flexibility to choose exactly what you need for your scene. So we've added realistic light to 2D smoke assets that didn't come with a normal map, so now we need to actually composite them into our scene, and we got a few more tips and tricks to show y'all on how to do that well. The first thing we need to do is make our smoke wider. As you can see in our main comp, our smoke is not filling up the entirety of the fire. So to fix this, we're going to select all 4 smoke layers and duplicate them. Let's move them down to the bottom and move them over to the left. Let's check our position over in our main comp and adjust as necessary. I'm also going to offset the time because I don't want my smoke layers to be identical. Once you offset the time, we do have to relink our normal and depth maps. And then we're going to follow all these same steps to make our smoke wider over towards the right. There are a lot of options within normality. You can invert dimensions, you can invert depths, you can do whatever you need to get a more realistic result. It all depends on what you're working with and what your scene looks like and the look you're trying to accomplish with it. Now that we've made our smoke wider, we can see that the timing isn't really working. The smoke is moving much slower than the fire. The fix for this is super simple. Just right click on the relit smoke comp, go to time, time stretch, and then we're gonna set the value to 30. The next thing to do is take our relighting and light the smoke with the fire. Duplicate the relight precomp and on the bottom layer, add a fill effect. Set this to black since we're dealing with black smoke. Duplicate the fire layer and add some sort of glow effect to it. As a personal preference, I'm using Deep Glow V2, but this effect also works with the standard glow effect that's built into After Effects. We're gonna go ahead and make the spread of the glow really wide. Since I don't want the fire doubling up, I'm going to go ahead and bring my source opacity to 0. We're gonna set the intensity to the desired result, and then we're gonna pick whip our new fire layer with the glow to the top relighting smoke precomp, and set the mode to Luma. And just like that, we have orange smoke. You might be thinking to yourself, hey Sam, why do I need to use the glow to relight the smoke if I already animated the lights? Couldn't I just set the tint on the relight smoke layer to orange and it'll look good? Yes, it will. But the benefit of doing it this way is that you can actually use the movement of the fire to light the different areas of the smoke. What we did with the lights when we animated those was that was just to create dynamic shadows and lighting areas on the smoke itself, creating movement. If we didn't animate the lights, the same spot on the smoke would always just illuminate with the fire. But now, the light actually moves all around the smoke as the fire laps up in those areas, creating a much more organic feel. After you set the track mat of the fire with the glow to the relit smoke, you can fiddle around with settings and figure out exactly what looks realistic by adjusting exposure or hue and saturation or applying a curves effect to the actual relit smoke layer itself to increase or decrease the contrast of the lighting. The customization options are endless. You can do whatever you want from here to get a more realistic result. You can go back and edit your normal map. You can go and move your lights around. You can do whatever you need. Sometimes good doesn't look real at all. So you just kind of gotta strike the balance and find that happy medium. One of the really great things about this method is that you can adjust it later, and you can also take what you already have and add other lighting effects. For example, we have the moonlight in this scene that's off to the left. We can duplicate the main relighting comp in our project window, and we can move our lights around and get them exactly where we need to be to mimic that moonlight. Then we can duplicate the relighting precomp in our main comp, select the moonlight comp in our project window, drag it down into our main comp while holding down the Alt key, and when you release it on top of the duplicated relit smoke layer, it puts it exactly where that was. From here, you change the blending mode to screen and add a tint effect, and voila, now you have moonlight on the smoke as well. And you can adjust all of these settings also. There is so much that you can do with this, it's honestly not even funny. I'm gonna add a little bit more movie magic, some glow, and a camera shake, and this is the final result. Let us know down in the comments what you would like to see a tutorial on next, or if you have any other ideas on how to improve the relighting of 2D assets, let us know. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope that you learned something useful and new within this video. The next video that we're gonna do about how to relight 2D assets is going to revolve around how to relight atmospheric smoke. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you can know exactly when we drop that. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you in the next one.